Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is DLAbaoaqu here. This is the first time I ever did one of these rant videos, so please bear with me. No, this video will not be about Irate Gamer's plagiarism. Everyone and their mother's uncle has done that. What I am going to talk about is his whitewashing of good games and calling them bad. His standards of what makes a game good or vague at best, and he ends up contradicting himself at times. For example, he criticized the NES port of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles arcade game on its graphics and not being able to play a four-player game. But in TMNT4 for the SNES, he forgave it for not having four players. Numerous people have called Irate Gamer out on his poor reviews. Among them, Big Al 2K6. RM821, Jacob04-1593, and Lewis Prower. They spoke their minds, and had videos deleted because of it. One of the biggest examples of Irate Gamer's ineptitude comes from his review of Super Mario Bros. 2. He began his review with a showcase reconstructed here of the three NES titles, Super Mario World, and Yoshi's Island, and singled out SMB2 as being bad. One of the first things he complained about was the enemy selection, citing Sniffits, Shy Guys, and Ba-Bombs. They've gone on to become recurring enemies in the series. In fact, they showed up in the next three games. As for not finding Bowser at the end, I could care less. That kind of thing doesn't necessarily make a game bad. Super Mario Land had Tatanka, Super Mario Land 2 had Wario, and Super Mario RPG had Smithy. What kind of factor does the final boss have in confirming a game's quality? If it's fun, does it really matter? He also complains that Toad is useless. You know what? He's right. Except for Toad being the fastest character. That claim's just like saying that Gutsman's weapon in Mega Man 1 is worthless. And you know the star in the video? You know the star that gives you invincibility? He slowed it down. I mean it, look at the grass. It's going slower than it's supposed to go. That just proves that he's just editing it so it can look worse than it actually is. And after all that is said and done, he pulls out his infamous line, after doing some research, and goes on about the Japanese Super Mario Bros. 2 and Doki Doki Panic, a story that most gamers have known since they were kids. Want to make himself sound knowledgeable, I guess. Then, he talks about Super Mario Advance for the Game Boy Advance, which he says finally made it feel like you're playing a Mario game, with new enemies and power-up items. And he said that right when he pulled up a giant vegetable. There's no power-ups in that game. That's something like a fire flower or a feather. There's no new enemies either. Just bigger versions. There is a new boss, though, replacing the second Mauser in the game. The only thing I've seen in it that's common in most other games is that it has a scorekeeping system. During the review, he said that the game was the worst one compared to the other games in the series. Truth be told, Super Mario Bros. 2 sold 7 million copies, making it the 5th best-selling NES game of all time. Electronic Gaming Monthly's 100 Best Games of All Time ranked it at 14th place. In conclusion, Chris Boers lied, manipulated the gameplay, and put on unnecessary skits. I don't recommend him to anyone. If you watch his videos of your own free will, I'm not going to be the one to stop you. But it's not going to change my mind that he doesn't do a good job.